Because every dog is different, we think their food should be too. Tails.com makes food that's nutritionally tailored just for your dog, at high street prices. We carefully mix ingredients to create a unique blend, delivered to your door every month at no extra cost. Make your dog a Tails.com dog. Go to Tails.com now. Enter code TAILSTV for your 2-week free trial.
So, a very warm Windsor welcome for Nigel Marsh. Thank you. So, the first of the toy breeds into the ring is the Australian Silky Terrier, followed by the Bichon Frise, followed by the Bolognese, the Cavalier King Charles, the Long Coat Chihuahua, and the Smooth Coat Chihuahua, the Chinese Crested, and the Coton de Tulier, the English Toy Terrier, and the Griffon Bruxellois, the Havanese, and the Italian Greyhound, the Japanese Chin, and the King Charles Spaniel, the Lurcher, the Maltese, the Miniature Pincher, excuse me, the Papillon, the Pomeranian, the Pug, and the Yorkshire Terrier. And the owner of the Pekingese apologises sincerely, but due to commitments at home, is unable to stay for the group this evening. He wishes all of the other Best of Breed winners the very best of luck. So as the dogs move into place, Nigel's wasting no time taking his first look at these superb Best of Breed winners. So we have 21 of the 23 breeds here. This was the largest of the two groups here today, and the second largest numerically of the groups overall behind the gun dogs that we saw here yesterday. There were 1,462 toys entered here at Windsor, which was 16% of our show. There are two things that every one of these that we see have in common. First and fairly obviously, they're similar stature and size. But secondly, and not so obvious, is their huge stature in personality. So, on the table now, for a closer examination by Judge Nigel, is the Australian Silky Terrier, judged today by Glenn Dimmock. This is a male, number 5235, originating in Australia, once known as the Sydney Silky. His ancestors are actually the Yorkshire Terrier that we'll see later, and the Australian Terrier, which we'll see tomorrow, which is itself derived from British rough-coated terriers. A keenly alert and attractive dogs, their active personalities, very formidable too. There are even references to the huge spirit of this little brain tackling snakes in its native Australia. Number 5235, the Australian Silky Terrier. Bichon Frise were judged by Lisa Malt, an entry of 62. This is another male, 5291. Bichon, Middle French, refers to a small long-haired dog. Frise, translates to curly haired. It's thought that the origin of the Bichon is the Canary Island of Tenerife, situated in the Mediterranean. They say that sailors as far back as the 14th century took these dogs home to France from Tenerife, and hence their popularity grew. Best of breed winning Bichon Frise male, this is 5291. Adele Summers was the judge of Polonese. Adele had an entry of 31. This is a male, 5319. Bologna in Italy around the 11th or 12th century is supposedly the origin of this very ancient breed. The Medici family are known to have bred known Bolognese. And other celebrated historical figures involved with the Bolognese are Madame de Pompadour, Catherine the Great, and also Maria Theresa, Empress of Austria. There's quite a few toy puppies not there for pre-judging, and this is your last chance, so please make your way to the collecting rings now. Put your hands together for the Bolognese Best of Breed, 5319. On the table now, we see the Cavalier King Charles. June Hazel time judged the breed today with an entry of 190. Largest in the toy group today. This is a male, number 5424. And despite being a numerically popular breed in this group, the Cavalier didn't actually secure Kennel Club status until 1944. Ranks as one of the most popular of all the breeds of dogs. Its origins are somewhat hazy, of course closely linked to the King Charles Spaniel that we'll see later and the court of Charles II. It's larger in size than its cousin and has a longer muzzle too. Cavaliers come in four colour varieties, black and tan, Blenheim, ruby and tricolour. Here we see a Blenheim. The best of breed winning Cavalier King Charles, number 5424. On the table now we see the first of the two chihuahuas, the long coat chihuahua judged by Jeffrey Kerr, entry of 140. This is a male, number 5621. Although the breed's origins are debatable and probably South American, taking his name from the Mexican state of Chihuahua, this is most definitely the smallest breed of dog in the world. Came to prominence in 1895. Six, two, one, the long coat chihuahua. Caroline Holmes was the judge of the smooth coat Chihuahua. She had no true 85, and this is another male. In fact, they've all been males so far. This is 5707. It's just as much a big-hearted dog as his long-haired cousin that we've just seen. The smooth coat stole the hearts of America when the breed moved across the borders into Arizona and to New Mexico. Smooth coat's name is apt, for its coat has to be most definitely smooth, the soft texture close and glossy, with an undercoat and a ruff permissible too. Five, 707, the smooth coat Chihuahua now. Ray Moreland was in charge of the Chinese Crested, entry of 68. This is the first of the females today. This is 5814, first recognised by the Kennel Club in 1981. These unique little dogs come in two varieties, the hairless and the powder puff, and here we see a hairless. Some interesting famous owners of this lovely breed. Gypsy Rose Lee, star of the recently revived West End musical, was one such famous name. Number 5814, the best of breed winning Chinese Crested. Sheila Needham was our judge today for the Coton Studio. There are 21 Cotons here. This is a male, number 5846. This is the national dog of the island of Madagascar. Companion dog of the ruling tribe from Madagascar. They were called the Marinas. Tulia is now a port on the island, and indeed it's believed that pirate ships in the 16th and 17th centuries brought the coton to the island. Best of breed winning Cotton, 5846. Sir Geoffrey Kerr was also the judge of the English Toy Terriers today. Geoffrey's entry of 39 produced this male, number 5880. before the 1960s, the ETT, as it's become known today, was called the miniature black and tan terrier. Its history is closely linked to the larger Manchester terrier that we'll see on Sunday in the terrier group. Best of breed winning English Toy Terrier, number 5880. Jeffrey Davis was the judge of the Griffon Brooks Loir. From an entry of 25, this is a female that Jeffrey sent us through. This is 5907. Named after the city of origin, Brussels in Belgium, this charming breed can be traced way back, but it's the 19th century that began to see it gain in popularity. Queen Marie Henriette was a Griffon supporter at the dog shows in Belgium. She brought the breed much fame and much popularity. The breed was crossed with pugs in the late 1890s. The smooth Griffon came along, when they're known as the Petit Brabançon. Though now, of course, rough and smooth both come under the new name of a Griffon Bruxelles Loire, and here we see a rough. The best of breed winning a Griffon Bruxelles Loire, number 5907. Nigel now turns his attention to the Havanese, judged by Jill Peak. Jill had an entry of 34. This is a female, 5938. So we've moved from Belgium and from Europe all the way across the Atlantic Ocean to the island of Cuba, because the Havanese is the national dog of Cuba. The breed, as we see it today, was developed from the now extinct Blanquito de la Habana, which translates as the little white dog of Havana. The best of breed winning Havanese, 5938. Italian greyhounds were judged by Gay Bird, and Gay had an entry of 45. She chose this male, 6012, for Nigel to consider in our toy group this evening. Graceful, racy little dog claims a heritage dating way back to the days of Pompeii and even Egypt. Found his way to Britain in the 17th century. Popularized by artists such as Carpaccio, Van Dyck, very popular in royal palaces, Mary Queen of Scots, Charles I, Queen Anne, and Queen Victoria, a few of the royal supporters. Number 6012, the Italian Greyhound. Japanese Chins. Sheila Vincent was in charge today with 83. This is another male, 6017. This is described as an Oriental aristocrat, both in bearing and demeanour. Originated in China, in actual fact, making his way to Japan as a gift from one empress to another. The word Chin means cat-like. Another breed popularised by the royalty. Queen Alexandra was a fancier. Certainly did an awful lot to popularise this breed. Six, zero, one, seven. King Charles Spaniels were judged by Caroline Robinson, an entry of 65. This is another male, 6118. Like his cousin, the Cavalier that we saw earlier, King Charles II gave his name to this charming toy spaniel. In fact, Charles II was often seen to exercise and feed these spaniels in St. James's Park. Note the lovely domed head and shorter nose, which are just a couple of points which differentiate this super breed from its Cavalier cousin. On the table now we see the Lurchin. Joe Smith was the breed judge. He selected this male from 29. This is 6176. Known as the little lion dog due to the manner in which he's trimmed. Probably a European breed, although the origins are somewhat hazy. Listed as France being his homeland. Also established in Spain and Germany from the 16th century. First recognised here in 1971. Number 6176. Michael Quinney was our judge today for Maltese. Michael had an entry of 32. This is a male, number 6224. As the name suggests, it's generally understood that the breed's origins lay in the island of Malta. Maltese name has been said to have been derived from the Adriatic island of Majet, even a Sicilian town called Melita. In fact, its Latin name indeed is the Canis Militeus. But what we are certain of is that the Maltese ancient history, according to Charles Darwin, the breed does date way back to many years BC. Number 6, a 224. What a time to choose to do that. I want to embarrass my mummy. And I think she's achieved that. Or he, actually. Take your time. We're not in a rush. There you go, well done. I think that deserves a round of applause, don't you? That's better. So, Nigel now turns his attention to the miniature pincher, which is another breed judged by Michael Quinney. This is a female, this time 6235. Mimpins, as they are now affectionately known, first arrived in the UK from Germany in 1938 and probably evolved from the Manchester Terrier that we're going to see tomorrow. Lively, high-spirited little chap, curious, always busy, highly intelligent, and a really good companion. That's the Mimpin, number 6235. Papillons today were judged by breed specialist Joe Magri. Joe had an entry of 113 and selected this male, number 6288. The breed has two countries listed as its home, namely France and Belgium, in both of which it's known as the Continental Toy Spaniel. Louis XIV's court saw Papillons pampered and revered. Madame de Pompadour and Marie Antoinette were also fancies of the breed. The Papillon best of breed, number 6288. Pomeranians were judged today by Ambjorn Lindquist from Sweden. There's an entry of 57. This is a female, number 6433. Though Britain is listed as the country of development of the Pomeranian, he's a Spitz-type dog descended from a larger Arctic sled dog, finding himself in the show ring by way of Germany and northern Poland and the area of Pomerania. Queen Victoria was very interested in this breed, and after a visit to Florence in 1888, she certainly increased public awareness of this charming little toy dog. Best of breed winning Pomeranian, 6433. Amanda Ellis had an entry of 147 pugs today, and she selected this female, number 6519. And despite speculation as to the country of origin for the pug, it's seen that they came from the Orient. Indeed, China is listed as the breed's home country. It was William III who introduced the pug to the UK. Royal patronage has followed through the centuries. Queen Victoria, Edward and Mrs. Simpson, to name just a few. The best of breed winning pug, number 6519. And we come to the last of the breeds in this toy group, Windsor 2016. Yorkshire Terrier, judged by Pat Mitchell. This is a male, number 6657, selected from 28 here today. Comes from the same locale as the Airedale Terrier that we'll see tomorrow, the Ridings of Yorkshire, first seen around 1850. First entry in the Kennel Club stud book was 1862. But then it was called the Broken-Haired Scotch or Yorkshire Terrier. The current name of Yorkshire Terrier wasn't adopted until 1870. Best of breed winning Yorkshire Terrier, 6657. So, our judge, Nigel Marsh, is going to have one last look at the group in its entirety. big entry of toys here today for us at Windsor. So as Nigel moves along the line, can I ask you once again to just congratulate these dogs on winning through their breeds. Congratulations to all of you. So, very soon we will know which of the dogs Nigel's going to shortlist for a little bit more movement and closer examination. Of the shortlisted dogs. Is the Cavalier, the smooth coat Chihuahua. The Italian Greyhound, the Japanese Chin. The Lurchin, the Maltese. The Papillon and the Pomeranian. Thank you very much to those other best of breed winners. Put your hands together as they leave the ring. Sorry, the wind's just taken hold of my paperwork. If I could ask these shortlisted dogs to make their way round to the end. I know Nigel's going to have one last look and ask them to move one more time. Smooth coat Chihuahua, number 5707, sent through by Caroline Holmes. And the Italian Greyhound, the selection of Gay Bird, this is 6012. The Japanese Chin, the choice of Sheila Vincent, 60817. The Lurcher, 6176, chosen by Joe. Michael Quinney sent us through the Maltese, 6224. Joe Magri, who judged the Papillons today, and he sent us through. Number 6288. So this is the seventh male, which leaves one lonely female, which is the Pomeranian. One girl among seven males. Here we go, the Pomeranian, sent through by our Swedish judge, Björn Lindqvist. This is number 6433, the lone female in the toy group lineup. So as the Pomeranian makes its way back, we can have the balls into the ring. I'm sure our judge will have one last look, but we may as well get the balls into place, please. Very soon we will know who the fifth of our finalists will be. One last look from our judge, Nigel Marsh. And the winner of the toy group wins a 2016. It's the Japanese Chin, number 6017. Second goes to the Papillon, number 6288. Third to the Maltese, number 6224. And fourth to the Smooth Coat Chihuahua, 5707. Okay, round you go then, please. Congratulations to the Japanese Chin, the Papillon, the Maltese, and the Smooth Coat Chihuahua. Photographs will be taken outside.